Hi everyone. This is actually a companion video to my 3DS Max tutorial that I just released on how to model this cubic gyroid abstract that you see here. This is actually a render that I had done in 3DS Max using the Corona render engine, illustrating one possible use for the object as a 3D print. The procedure is almost exactly the same in Blender as it is in 3ds Max, with the exception of a few steps that are uniquely different in Blender. So I decided to make this video to show you how to get past those steps. Alright, we'll begin here in Blender. I'm using Blender 2.75. I should point out that I do have the dynamic spacebar menu and the Pi menu add-on activated, and I'll be using them in this tutorial. I also have the icons development add-on activated. These are all available in 2.75 in the preferences add-ons, user preferences. Alright, so anyway, we'll begin here with just the cube, and in the 3ds Max video I began with a proprietary object in Max that we don't have in Blender, so we'll have to create the object from scratch, and that's not going to be a problem. It's just a matter of beginning here with a cube, and we'll go down into the edit mode and we'll select all of the vertices, and then holding down control and shift on the keyboard, we'll tap the B key for bevel, and we'll just bevel out those vertices until they're just about touching like that. Okay, and actually we only want one bevel, and it should look like this. The vertices should be almost touching, and then what you can do is tap the W key to bring up your specials and go to the remove doubles and just adjust the merge distance until you see that you've removed 12 vertices and all of those points have been merged, and you should have this object. Alright, so here's the starting point we did in 3ds Max. The only difference here now, we're just going to rotate this a little bit. So we'll go back out to object mode and we'll rotate it on the x-axis here. So we'll hit rotate, and then we'll tap the X key to isolate it to the x-axis, and we'll just hold down the control button and we'll rotate it 45 degrees. Alright, so this is it right here. And then we'll move the object up a little on the plane, and we'll go ahead and snap our cursor to center. Well, actually, we'll snap it to the selected, I'm sorry. Alright, so this is the starting point we have here. Alright, so now we'll go back down into edit mode, and we'll go to faces, and we'll select one of the quadrilateral diamond-shaped faces on the object here. And then we'll shift G to bring up our select similar, and we'll just select polygon sides to capture all of the four-sided faces. Alright, now we could from this point we want to extrude all of these faces, so we could hit the Alt E hotkeys and bring up our extrude panel, and we'll select individual faces and hold down the control button and just extrude to 1.0. okay, and then just click on the left mouse button to confirm that action. Alright, now we want to repeat this, so we can do the same action again, the Alt E, select individual faces, or on the left hand side we can scroll down to our history rollout and just repeat last, and now we have two extrusions of 1.0. okay, so this is where we are right now, and at this point we can hold down control and tap the plus key on the number pad to grow the selection once, and then hold down Alt and tap the E key, and again individual faces, and then hold down the control button while you pull out the extrusion one more time, and we'll pull them out to 1.0. Tap the left key to accept that. All right, so here's our fractal looking object at this point. Okay, so now the next step is going to be to scale these selected faces just slightly. Okay, but we want to do it on their individual origins, so we're going to go down here to the pivot point, and we're going to change it to individual origins. All right, and then we will tap the S key, and then holding control, we'll just pull it out to about 1.2. All right, no more than that. All right, so what we've done is just scale these faces up a little bit. Okay, so now that we have that, we can go ahead and tap the X key and delete faces. Okay, so now the next step. Now, if you'll notice, what you might want to do is tap number one on the number pad and go to the front perspective view. And this will help us determine where we are in relation to the object for the next steps. Now, if you notice here what we're looking at, if we just rotate slightly until we're looking down through one of these holes, you'll see that the extruded arms of this object are in a cross shape when we look at it from this angle. And if we roll the object down, they're still in a cross shape all along this side of the object if you're in the front view. Okay, so I tapped on one on the number key to go to front, and then I just rolled it up till I'm looking down one of these holes, and you'll see that these are in the X shape. Now, if we go ahead and tap three on a number pad, we'll go to the right perspective, and you'll see that the arms in this case are in a cross or a plus sign. Okay, so that's the side arms. What we want to do is go to the front, roll down until we're looking at a 45 degree angle down through one of these holes, and we're going to begin by working on one of these X shapes. Okay, and we're going to go to edge mode, and we're just going to roll slightly to the side here so we can see one of these open armed extrusions on the side, and we want the bottom edge of one of these arms here in the X formation. We want the bottom edge, and we're going to hold down shift and also select the edge directly across from it, and we're going to tap F on the keyboard to create a face between there, and it's basically just created a bridge between those two edges. Okay, and then after you do that, select the edge on the new face that you've created, hold down shift and select the edge closest to it, and then just tap the F key to create a bridge between those edges as well. Alright, now let's roll over to the other side, and we're going to do the same thing here. Select the bottom edge on that open arm, and then the edge across from it, okay, on that arm. Tap the F key to create a face, then select the edge right on that new face that you just created, the longest edge, and then select the edge right underneath it, the closest edge to it, and tap the F key again. All right. So now we've connected these arms to the arms on the other extrusion. All right. So now let's roll down. So here's the one we just did. Let's roll down a little bit, and now we'll do the same thing on the bottom arms. So select this one and this one, tap the F key, create a face, then select the edge on that new face and the other edge right below it, and then close that up. All right, same thing on the other side, this edge and this edge, F key, this edge and this edge, F key. All right, let's roll down to the next X shape here. And since the top two arms are already connected, we're going to work on the bottom ones, this edge and this edge, F key, and then the new edge, and then that one right next to it, and same thing on the other side, and then the new edges, connect those up. And if we roll again, we have one more to do, so we'll start on this side. It's this one and this one, and then this one and this edge. Okay. Now just make sure while you're doing this procedure that you are selecting only the edges you wish to select. Selecting incorrect edges could, devastate the procedure, so you want to be sure that you do have the correct edges selected before you create the face. Alright, so now we're all connected up. Let's go back and tap on the one key again. We'll go to the front view. And if we spin around to the back, you'll see that was the last one we worked on. Now they're all connected up. Alright, so now what we want to do is, from the front view here, looking down the hole, every one of these extrusions has a top square open face here on the top of the object. Alright, so each one of these X's has an open face on the top, and then each one of these cross shapes has an open face on the top. Alright, so let's begin with the X's. We want to grab one of the edges on the top of the open face, and we want to select the top edge on one of the arms on that exact extrusion and create a face to combine those together, or to merge them together, just like this. And I'm just going around that topmost open face and connecting each open edge with the top edge of the associated arm of that object. Okay, so that's what we did there. Rolling down to the next X, grabbing that edge and this edge, creating a face. All right, I'm just going to do that on each and every one of them. Now at this point, I could probably, I did an error there. At this point, I could probably just pause the video until I've completed all of these bridging actions. But it really doesn't take that long in the end, so I may not pause it and just allow you to see the entire procedure as I had done as well in the 3ds Max tutorial. Just in case anything goes wrong, I could show you how to fix it, but it looks like we're almost done here anyway, so I don't think I'll pause it. Okay, so here we are. This is the last X shape. Now, as you can see here, I wasn't looking properly and I selected the incorrect edge, so I didn't create the face on it. So just create the faces on the proper edges. Now we've done that all the way around. Let's go to the side, the cross-shaped ones, and we're going to do the same. We're going to select that edge and this edge and create a face. All right. So it's quite simple, really. It's more monotonous than anything. You're probably wondering why I just don't select all of the edges at once and do a bridge operation, and I promise you that that would not result in a shape that we could work with. The bridge operation would fail, in fact, and that holds true in almost every application. This is the way it has to be done, more or less. All right, so one by one. All right, so that monotony is completed. This is how the object should look at this point. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll go to face mode, select all the faces, and just click Control N to invert the normals. All right, and then we will go out to object mode, go to the modifier tab, and we'll apply a subdivision surface modifier with just one iteration at this point. Go ahead and apply that. And then we'll go back down into edit mode. Go to vertices and select all. And then in the left-hand side, scroll up until you see smooth vertex. Go ahead and select that and click it just once. And we'll smooth these vertices and spread the edges out just a little bit and give it a nicer, more appealing topological result. Alright, now we'll switch to edge mode and we'll just go down here, and as you can see now here, I'll tap the one key again. Now we're in the front facing perspective view, and along the side here you can see we have three edges close together, and that is everywhere on the object that these arms are extruding from. Alright, what we want to do is select the middle edge in between all three of these edge loops. All right, select both of these middle edges here, and we'll do it again over here. Actually, hold down shift and do it again over here. The wrong ones, the middle ones. There we go. Now we can try to hit shift G and select similar by length. Okay, and you'll notice that that captures a few extra edges, and we'll see if we can remedy that over here in the threshold panel. We'll go 0.001. All right, and see if we have all of them. Well, that actually didn't work entirely, so let's go with 0.005. That's too much. 0.002. Okay, so apparently select similar in this case is not going to work as it did in 3ds Max. So what we'll do is we'll just go ahead and manually select all of the remaining edges on the object in that location. All right. If select similar is not working properly, then there's no alternative other than to manually go around the object and select the edges. I'm sure if we sat here and experimented more with select similar and different profiles, perhaps down in vertex mode, and you know, painstakingly tried to find out what worked, we might eventually get it. But in this case, it was painless just to go around and select the edges manually anyway. All right, so we have all those edges selected, and what we're going to do is just tap X and dissolve edges. And that's just to give us a cleaner, more even topology in that area. So when we go ahead and apply some more subdivision surface modifier later, it's not going to create any pinching in here, at least not as badly as it would have. All right, so here we are in the front view again, and I'm just examining the object to make sure that everything has been taken care of, and it looks like it has. All right, so now I can go out to object mode. At this point now, we're almost complete. We can go to the solidify modifier, and we'll put a high quality, we'll check the high quality mark. We'll change the offset to 0.0, and we'll apply a thickness of 0.2. All right, so that leaves us with this. And then we'll go ahead and apply a subdivision surface modifier on top of that. And we'll increase the iterations to 3. All right, now we still have our solidify modifier active, so we'll change the inner amount to 1. That's on the crease value, the inner amount to 1 and the outer amount to 0.5. to give us a nice thick result in here. Alright, so if we do take this to 3D print, we could in fact create a hollowed out object, which would allow for a more cost efficient print. Otherwise, this would be a rather expensive item depending on the size that you chose to model at. Alright, so if you're just going to use it as a digital asset for rendering, 3 iterations on the subdivision surfaces is good enough. Let's look at it now with the flat view. I would recommend perhaps even going to 4 if you're going to 3D print, because you can see how nice and smooth the result is with that. All right, so in this case now, we can bring it down to 3 just for these purposes, and we'll switch it to a smooth shading. And then we'll go over here and we'll just go to properties and apply a matte cap, and we'll change that to the silver, and there is the object all completed. All right, so I just want to thank everybody for watching. I hope this was helpful, and if you have any questions or if there were any problems in the procedure that you didn't understand, don't hesitate to let me know. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel for many more. Hope you enjoyed it. See you again soon.